Patrick Rasumi, where you at, your motivation guy. That's right, ladies and gentlemen, I am back pumped up as ever to bring you guys the latest and greatest tips and tricks to make you the best Fortnite player. This is your motivation guy, Keith Allen. You know, by now you should have had enough time to really explore the new POI and have formed a few opinions about which ones you like the most. So now you may be wondering, what are some of the best POIs to really land on if you want to play competitively? Luckily, okay, we got your back today, man. And we got a nice selection of landing spots that's going to get you quick mats, amazing weapons, and plenty of eliminations. But before we get into this, you already know my favorite candy. It's that Bunch of Crunch. You need to get that right now. And let's get this going, because here are some of the top spots to start dropping at, like right now. All right, so POIs come in a variety of shapes and sizes. And so with Chapter 3, we finally have a break from those greens and oranges, replacing them instead with white snow, orange canyons, deep green tropics, and, even the stony brown terrain of the Daily Bugle. Most importantly, though, man, is the unique opportunities for finding chests. As someone who's interested in playing competitively, you need to know what are the best POIs so that you can just plan ahead and make the most out of your drop zones. You know, with Chapter 3, we have plenty of interesting name drop spots, as well as some that you're not going to find highlighted on your map. So whether you want to land on a contested area or have some chests all to yourself, there is something on this list for everybody's game plan. So one of the new structures that replaces the good old IO bases is the 7 camps. So like Season 7 of the previous chapter, these bases are riddled with guards who luckily are non-hostile, at least until you attack them. However, killing one of these guards is actually a decent way of getting a quick blue AR at the start of the game. Not only that, but it's just a great spot to really pick up a blue weapon, but it also has plenty of access to trees and rocks that can really help you guys out. However, the 7 bases have a secret to them that you're not going to find unless you go underneath the surface. Within the compounds are a vault that you may have already noticed as you explore the new locations. And so if you play primarily on solo, then the vault interface will notify you that 2 players are required to be present for the vault to open. However, my friends, do not fret, because there is another way to really get in, which ironically will have you attacking the non-hostile guards that roam the area. Okay, so head back up to the surface and find the nearest guard. As soon as you find them, aim for the head, and they should really go down pretty easily. Next up, pick them up and bring them down to the basement with you. There, you're gonna need to let the vault interface scan you and the guard. This is gonna register as a second player and allow you to access to all the goodies hidden on the other side. So, what are these treasures? Good question. Well, your reward for performing this simple task is various henchmen chests, which contain, you know, rare loot to really get you set up quickly. So due to the variety of locations that have vaults, there is a 7 base for whichever area that you want to land in, from map corners to deep within the heart of the island. Another benefit of landing at a 7 base is gaining access to rifts. These rifts allow you to redeploy and really can be used for rotation, spotting enemies from above, and making a quick escape. Now, if someone out there killed all the guards already and you find yourself without the necessary body to really, you know, get past the vault, I'm telling you right now, there is an alternative option which is quite silly, but it works. Holding on to a chicken also counts towards the security clearance. So remember, 7 guards and chickens are the key to really getting into vault if you're playing solo. All right, guys. So to learn more about how to optimize your loot route and your rotations, you got to check out ProGuys.com by clicking on the link below. There you can get in contact with one of our professional coaches who can help guide you as you navigate through the competitive season in Chapter 3. This is professional level coaching, man, normally reserved for pros, and it's guaranteed to help you guys improve your skills and get that victory royale. All right, speaking of rare loot, this next drop spot feels like a treasure. I'm telling you, especially for players that want to start the game stacked. Good weapons, excellent consumables, and even a decent range of materials to really get you started. This is, of course, is the Castaway Raft. However, what makes this landing spot special is that it never stays put in the same place. So to find it, you're going to need to scan the map during the bus ride and spot it. So keep those eyes on the different shores around the map. You should spot it in the distance looking like a raft. Once you got your sights locked on it, you can start heading over there. So once you land, you're gonna always be, you know, a short distance away from the shore, and you know, you can just immediately get into work, you know, looting the new IO chest variant known as the Henchman chest. These chests are guaranteed to spawn on the raft, and it's gonna give you guys some really good loot with better chances of getting an epic or legendary weapon. And on top of that, this spawn has a guaranteed crate that really drops down from above. Okay, so inside, you're gonna also have better chances of getting an epic or legendary. Good weapons are only the tip of the iceberg. However, you're also gonna have chests, slurp barrels, and even foraged items inside non-boxes. Inside, you're gonna be able to find items such as the mushroom and the peppers, which is gonna help you have a well-rounded loadout right from the start. Okay, so Butter Barn is a drop spot not too far from Risky Reels. Like the raft, this is a good place to really find foraged items found within the non-boxes, as well as harvest metal from the surrounding area. This is a great way to max out your shield early due to the mushrooms you can find. And so this is not only, you know, the source of shields to be found, there are an abundance of slurp barrels in the basement of Butter Barn, which allow you to fill up on shields quite quickly. Not only that, you can also harvest plenty of metal from these barrels as well as the surrounding storage shelves and kitchen appliances when you want to create some harder to destroy builds. On top of these perks, there are also two possible icebox spawns, one at Butter Barn as well as one at the gas station in front of it. Okay, so here, I mean like right here, you have the chance of finding some delicious fish, which are a must have for really patching up your shields quickly during combat or healing a good chunk of health. The gas station also contains a quad crasher spawn, which is going to help you get to where you need to go to next. Okay, also in Butter Barn, you're going to find the NPC Man Cake Win Challenge will give you guys an epic SMG and a ranger rifle. So challenging him can be a quick way to get epic weapons right from the start. If you're interested in earning gold, there is also a bounty board which can be found on this location. So do not miss out. Crackshot's Cabin sounds familiar. I wonder where I saw that. So nostalgia aside, man, this is actually a really decent place to land, giving you access to vehicles, chests, as well as a guaranteed llama spawn. There are around 5 chests to find, which is great for a POI away from the main areas. There are also 2 quad crashers in the area, which is, at the moment, I mean, are some of the best ways to get across the snowy terrain and the perfect way to start your rotation. Now, 5 chests and a vehicle might be fine, but really, what makes this POI so special? Well, let me tell you this, man. If you want some exotic items and even max out on your match right from the get-go, then you're going to be interested in knowing about the llama in the nearby barn house. Like the crate from the Castaway Raft, this llama is guaranteed to spawn every single game. So let me tell you this, man, go after it and bring it down as quickly as you can, because there are some goodies inside, I'm telling you right now. Not only that, but you're also going to receive max mats, but you're also going to really be able to really get some chili chug, which is a great item for competitive matches. Shell or High Water is a POI located at the topmost of the island. This is a spot for someone who wants to loot plenty of chests, but also stay close to all the action. There are plenty of trees here for you as well to harvest wood. The bushes from the hedge maze are, you know, an excellent way to really max out that inventory. There are also around 15 possible chest spawns, so that you can increase your chances of getting a decent loadout consisting of healing items and weapons. And so if this POI wasn't good enough already, I'm telling you right now, it also in close proximity in 3 of the major POIs, making it an excellent spot to really start rotating after your initial drop. These POIs are Logjam Lumberyard, Shifty Shafts, and Sleepy Sounds. So if you want to chase after those eliminations, you have plenty of choices for moving forwards. This spot also has a reboot van in case you run into some trouble in the early game process. Once again, don't forget to visit ProGuys.com for professional grade coaching that's going to help you master your drops and early game strats. All right, guys, the Sanctuary is one of the main new POIs on the Chapter 3 Island and also one of the most popular. Because of this, it's often contested by other players. However, if you have a, you know, really good fighting skills, this can be an excellent place to really score elimination points. Our recommendation would be to avoid the center of the POI and instead try landing on one of its edges. Here, and I mean like right here, you're going to get the chance to third-party opponents without being the center of attention. And this location is also the home of various 7 guards, while, you know, like the previous bases, give you blue ARs upon dispatch. However, beware, guys, the Foundation will also be roaming the area, and making him hostile will result in a battle against a boss enemy. Nobody messes with family, man. So if you happen to survive the battle and really take him down, you can get the Mythic 7 AR, which is an absolute beast to use and a worthy addition to your loadout. Bunch of questions, tell me where you at, your motivation guy. That's right, I am back. Hope you guys enjoyed the video and learned something new today so you can be the best Fortnite player that you can possibly be. If you guys like the video, make sure you guys subscribe to the channel. And I'm telling you right now, feel free to leave a comment and let us know if there's anything that you would be interested in learning more about. So until the next time, make sure to eat that Butcher Crunch, and I'll see you in the next one. Peace.